huge numbers, 358 in the NCAA tournament, and then also dime a dozen, and that is a volleyball term. When you dime a pass, you control the other team's serve perfectly, run your offense to perfection.
And the first point of the match.
Hard. Both teams come out, how hard they had to work, and finally Texas not able to track that ball down.
If we'll be to 25, you've got to win by two. If we go to a fifth set, it's shortened. Block at the net by Amy Neal. She's number 9 in white, and there is Katie Rolfson. So the two All-Americans getting some early touches here. The crowd did not think that that last attempt cleared the net. And now here comes Nebraska again with Rolfson. It's popped up in the back by Chiako Bagu. And the middle set to CeCe Hall. The serve from Annika Albright. She's a serving specialist who comes in. And Amy Neal tools the. They cannot attack at the net. Collins, the slide behind. We're going to be talking about
it. I see good defensive positions. That's another thing leading to these long rallies.
Terrific head coaches and great staffs that they have put together, their assistants. It's Nebraska left to the Big Ten. Collins out to Prieto. Sarame got it through the block and they went.
And what we call daylight. Watch the middle just took a little step the opposite way.
All Big 12 performer who helped them take a little pressure off of Amy Neal this year and the ace.
Between passers, well executed by Collins. That now she switches and serves more cross court.
There's this behind for Amber Rolfson. Free ball Nebraska. Hunter will go cross court this time to Kelsey Fien for the.
Across the net in time.
That was Chiako Bagu, the All-American middle, number 11 in white for Texas. She'll get a swing right here.
What a nice by Fien there to create the scoring opportunity.
And the
great blocking move. Watch as she goes all by herself solo, swings her arms, get in the perfect position. That allows Hall, the middle, to work.
Back to serve. The twin sisters side by side for the Huskers throughout their careers from nearby Papillion, Nebraska. And the kill.
And then run that slide attack.
Hunter to Fien, sent right back by Texas.
Final match against Minnesota that's sealed.
Outer for set. That may not be the case tonight if she has to exit. It's Fien, solo block for Amy Neal. They'll go right back outside. Pat Brooks to Neal. Hunter. Katie Rolfson calling for it.
And here, watch McCade. She's going to sit her arms right there, and the field goal only worth one, but good vision by the hitter to take advantage.
Bedarhani. There's the freshman. We talked about those two go head to head over on the right side, and a stuff.
Exactly. Again, I'm impressed with the positioning. Taking all cross court on Neal, she that opening down the line, but the block and the defense for both teams in good spots. That's why these long rallies are happening.
Outside of Fecky off the block. Yeah. Texas also won the last AIAW national championship back in 1981. Bedarhani with a boomer down the line.
Yep, lots of weapons. They could set any one of their hitters in these offensive patterns, except when you get a pass like that. Nice. Right over the block and down.
John Kayla Fecky hits it as hard as anybody they've ever had here at Nebraska, the freshman from Iowa.
And another good block touch by Nebraska.
Amy Neal through the block for the.
Hitting on the left and switching Katie Rolfson from the left to the right.
Through the set in the middle to Amber Rolfson.
That one signal, they're serving that right back zone. And they pull the setter a little off the net. Well, down on the bench, his players had some conversations with him. And they thought, you know what? We might play with a little less stress if you go down to the end of the bench. And he figured, what? I'll give it a try. And it's worked really well for Texas here in the final. But another.
Five, we're going to 25 points. Got to win by two. Kelly Hunter. Back to Fecky, who's already got six kills now in the first set.
Out of that, from somebody like Dally Santana, the great outside hitter from Minnesota, but not much of the off-speed shot. That's a smart thing when you've hit than hitters for a cool 667 hitting percentage.
Hunter to Rolfson, not only Nebraska over Texas in 1995. It is the dream of so many young Nebraskans.
Faced the journey and the challenge of trying to make the semifinals. Opportunity for Texas there with the bad pass. Nice set.
Collins sets up. Amy Neal can't put it down. Fien off the ricochet. Neal able to keep it up. Back outside to the All-American. Right at Justine Wong-Arantes, the Big Ten Defensive Player of the Year. And she allows Fien to get
best when she hits higher off that right hand, and she uses that right hand a bit hard.
Hunter serves. That's a Bagu trying to tip it in the middle. Good right. Coverage by Rolfson. Fien had to roll it. Now a chance for Texas in transition. Neal, couple blockers were there waiting. Bump to Bedardani down the line. Good save by Albright. The joust at the net, point Texas.
He on the depth chart, yeah. Really wasn't expected to take over, but two injuries put her right there as their whole depth chart now at opposite.
Texas lost a couple of players that they thought would be big contributors this year, but the injury sideline them, and Bedardani has stepped into the void. Fecky with another swing coming right in off this women's national team. We are headed to 25 points, got a win by two. The first set, best 3 of 5 for the national championship.
I serve aggressively, you gotta be okay with a few misses.
Neal right at Wong-Arantes with a good get up. And how about McCoy responding? Prieto Cerame is stuff. They'll go back out to Paulina. The Rawson twins were right there. Hunter to Katie and a solo block for Prieto.
Near blocks. Watch those hands, that left hand especially. A solo one-on-one block forcing the hitting 7 for 10 with no errors.
Pretty good option to go to there, the freshman. Let's see if they go back to her. There they go. Two in red.
Nice,
dug up by McCoy. Prieto Cerame getting some swings and a terrific defense. Hunter, they'll go back to the freshman. And Fecky gets
it. When that thing gets past the block, watch it just catches Amy Neal by surprise. It's flat, barely crossing the net, no spin. But Neal controls it well.
Prieto Cerame.
And Katie Rolfson, who even though she's playing opposite, she's in the passing formation. They serve her, perfect pass.
Hunter to Fien, popped up by McCoy. Not the best of chances. Now Nebraska, the slide and the kill for Rolfson. Amber Rolfson serving. Prieto Cerame into the block, stuffed in the back.
Far Texas got to figure out a way to get her some better looks. They did not. They could choose a much different matchup if they so chose.
Justine Wong-Arantes, the libero from Cypress, California. One of the best that they have had here. It's been a position that has produced a bunch of national team members. Good job by Nebraska to try and keep that going. Back to Amy Neal. This is Nicole Dalton. Becky going deep.
Antenna, that ball has to go cross court. Still, Texas not ready.
Dalton with the pass to Collins. Cross court to Neal, stuffed up.
She made the switch in the spring, and look at her get up, get those hands. Just feasting at the net as a blocker. Coach Cook calls that her best skill. That's one of the reasons, confusion by Michaela Fett.
By the way, in the regular season loss to Texas, nor did Bedardani for the Longhorns. When they met back in September.
Her favorite animal.
That's how you tell her apart from her sister. Molly McKay in the NCAA tournament. That may be coming soon. And that time.
Beats the stuff. Collins repeating, getting the kill for Abagu.
Abagu's the 6'2 junior from Texas. Following in mom's footsteps and trying to go one better and win a title. Actually redshirted last year and waited the Lone Star State. And that's what makes it even more special is they've got a lot of players that fans have grown up watching from.
But this is going to be good for you and good for the team.
Yeah, I believe his words were, oh, shoot. It's a good problem to have. You know? Grandmother, who's one of her biggest fans, and whenever she goes back to visit relatives in Africa, she brings newspaper clippings and deep. We're having an issue right now, though, with the freshman on the other side of the net. Fecky has 10 kills now tonight. Collins to the other rookie, and Bedard Ani says, all right.
Bedard Ani just crushing this ball cross court. You see her face straight ahead and then bring her arm across. That's a tougher one to read as a blocker.
She's coming off a career high, 15 kills in the semis. McCage going behind.
Watch her. She's a blocker coming all the way from the left side of the court to the right side of the court, positioning from defense to offense.
Becky tools the block.
Down for a point for the other team, tips it softly off the block.
Volleyball hitting percentage is like a batting average. You want to be over 300. 400 is terrific. Back to Fecky. Overpass, you are allowed.
It has to go outside. Watch, this is a great view. It's going to come. It had to go to the left of that antenna, but it went, and then they cannot play that ball. It's blown dead at that point.
Collins likes McCage.
It's wise of Texas. If they're not getting as much production from Neal in front of the setter on the left side, they're just going to go back behind, but Nebraska returns.
Receive of Fecky.
You want to get your ball to your most efficient hitters.
They will continue to serve Neal to keep her busy. And there's Prietos Rame. So they
get your ball, get the most opportunities to your most efficient hitters. You got to keep.
Kat McCoy, the sophomore out of Southlake, Texas. Over on two for Hunter, and Dalton was there. Back to Prietos Rame. Back outside to Paulina, stuffed.
Much fun because there is absolute heat coming at you from people like Paulina Prieto Sarame on one side of the net, the Rolfson twins. When it and on it just right, there's no chance for the other team to play that ball. And
Nebraska, midway through the second set, it's a 1-0 lead for Nebraska. They're up a couple points, make it three now.
Been working on all season. This is what we've been building for. They had to be mentally tough to get here in a five-set comeback against Florida. He's asking them to be more mentally tough right now and make better decisions.
Overpass, and Abagu was there.
Scoring chance.
Two aces, two good blocks for Nebraska. The difference so far in this set. Pancake dig for Prietos Sarame, and then crushed by Bedard Ani.
Prietos Sarame was on the floor. She's on the floor. Where does it go? It has to go back.
From Nicole Dalton. Much better pass there.
And this is really Obagu's responsibility. She's a little, you have the slide attack. The middle blocker has to help control that setter.
That went inside the antenna for Texas. Obagu was there to slow it down. Bump to Fien. Off the block and out. Point hustle. Hunter continue to go after Amy Neal. Bedard Ani up against one blocker in the middle.
We call that a two set, just about 2 feet above the tape in the middle of the court, and she puts it away.
On the overpass right to Fien.
Opportunities, didn't only play 9 out of the first 16 matches.
Her best match of the year was in the semis as Obagu is blocked. Juan Arantes able to pop it up. Katie Rolfson, no. Transition for Nebraska. Fecky with the tip.
Nice read by Collins.
Bedard Ani well off the net. Turned back by Hall. Good back row D. Back to Fecky, and nobody was there.
Championships and just seeing what's possible out there, it's so inspiring.
8 kills in the first set. 5 more in this set. Hunter. In the middle, Rolfson. Neal. Amy Neal now.
And then at least 1 point. Neal taking a little something off, lining the floor.
Going to 25, got a win by two. Back to Fecky, through the block, right at Abagu. Collins able to run it down. Here comes Neal again, looking for three in a row, won't get it. Back row, Albright into the block. Some traffic on the Nebraska side. It's a tight set. Here comes Texas. Collins in the middle to McCage. Kept alive. Albright with a nice play. Back set. Better. Hadi. Point Longhorn.
If Fecky had turned and come up with that stuff, Albright. Exactly.
Here is Abago with the serve.
And she causes problems with it. Nicely done.
Fecky dug up. Collins.
Good. Poor communication.
Juan Arantes serving. Neal. Bad pass. And it's cleaned up by Ben Arantes.
So just like the great start of Fecky, seven kills, no errors on 12 swings.
Dalton floats one over. Hunter to Fecky. Got it.
When she's the finisher, but not necessarily setting up the play.
Dalton, Collins, and the block gives Nebraska the lead. The response of roof, roof, roof from the crowd.
Yep, Ralston working really hard to play for a middle to move that quick laterally and get there.
Amy Neal. Back row Ralston. Dalton will set it back to Neal. The double block is up to slow it down. Fecky. Set point.
Nebraska starting with the same server in Kelly Hunter. And immediately it pays off. I'm not surprised by that move. It's what I would have done too. Just looking, and immediately they get a lose two games. Sorry, she had McCage in the four games.
Back set to Fien, dug up by McCoy. Back row attack for Neal, coming right back at her. Outside to Prieto Cerame, and already a couple of Kim amnesia here in hostile territory, down 0-2. Trying to do what has been done only three times in 35 years, and that's rally from down 0-2 in the finals. Katie Rolfson, good defense for Texas. Abagu in that set.
Get the ball to Abagu. See how she had to reach and fly forward just to touch that. But I like the thinking. You want the ball to somebody like Abagu. And yet,
Monica Albright.
So it's between the left and middle passer. Pumpkin hitting error of this whole match.
Eight kills in the first set, eight more in the second, and they go right back to her. Yells, go, 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 get her the ball. Back set, the slide to Abagu. Good Nebraska defense this time.
Oh, that's too close.
Long Arantes down to pop that ball up. Bump down to Prieto. Cerame rejected.
Yes.
And that's what Jared Elliott just told McCoy. Go out.
Off the net.
Hunter. The slide is stuffed by Neal. Hunter pushes it across. Brooks will bounce it back to the outside. Another good block for Nebraska. Not much Neal could do with that. Pretty much a free ball here for the Huskers, and Fecky
got a hold of it, and she comes diving in to keep it alive.
Serves it tough as well. Neal got a running start at it.
More offense on the right side of the court.
Fien off the block. Point.
Little surprised.
This is Amber Rolfson. Dalton wasn't sure if that was going to go long, so she played it. Hunter tracks it down, dumps on two.
Kelly Hunter is making some nice choices. Just as I like it when just the activity, the movement attracts blocker's attention. In the center.
Struck her like a lightning bolt. I want to be a Husker. I want to try and win a national championship for the Big Red, wearing the same jersey that her mother once wore at Nebraska. And one of three starters from Papillion, a suburb of Omaha, setting up Fien for the kill.
In fact, Her mom is the church secretary for the Rolfson twins, so that hometown figuring heavily for these Cornhuskers.
The pitching are now out there on the floor themselves. If they win this set, they win the title. Career high. She's got 19 already on the night. Hunter, gonna go to her. Slowed down by Texas Collins. Good speed to get there. Prieto Cerame dug up by Juan Arantes. Collins has to track down another one. Off speed from Paulina.
Laying it out with her right hand. But the thing was that she kept it well on her side of the net. Still Texas adjusting. I like Prieto Cerame to have to move much to run their offense. Having on the move again for Hunter.
Rolfson gets the Juan Arantes, tough serve to McCoy. Texas unable to get a good swing on it. On the overpass, Rolfson decides to keep it on her side of the net. By her sister won't go down. Quick to Obagu. Good play by Albright. Now it's back to Fecky. Collins, the back set, Bedard Hani, freshman on freshman.
That's the choice.
Hunter, quick in the middle. Collins digs it up. Overpass, slammed home. Bye.
She's getting up so high. You got to get up really high to get it around Obagu.
Record from 7 years ago in this building as well. It's been a great.
Great move by Katie Rolfson there, and so Texas switches its alignment again, brings Paula Prieto Sol passing with just two players, McCoy and Neal. There's a better pass.
Prieto Cerame gets the kill, and with their fourth national championship. Neal unable to get much heat on it. Obagu does. Point Texas, the winningest in school history, the first Texas team to get to four straight national semifinals, trying to bookend their careers with a second national championship.
That's where you got to set. I don't know why they keep setting the left.
Nebraska gunning for its fourth national championship. Texas, its third NCAA title and fourth overall. Point Huskers. Yeltz will be back next year with another top-notch recruiting class. Collins to Neal, the senior. Hunter to Fecky. Dug up by Neal, Bedard Hani. Terrific deep.
Paid out.
Hunter, the slide and the kill for Amber Rolfson. Going right at Brooks. Collins sets up Bedard Hani. Slowed down by the Huskers and a chance here. Feed. Back outside to Neal. She'll roll it. Good coverage for the Huskers. Back row. Rolfson with the tip. The that one home. Hunter. Amber Rolfson crushes it, and there are five. Free ball, Texas. Dalton to Prieto Cerame. Chance for the Huskers to win it. Tough set for Rolfson to deal with, and Texas fights off another. On the overpass, joust at the net, comes across to Texas. Prieto Cerame off the tips. Hunter to Kelsey Fien. The Huskers win it at home for their fourth national champ. Win tonight. They lost to Texas in September, and that was the reason why they made the changes. And it is Kelsey Fien